Today we are starting with our next topic that includes theorem of perpendicular axis and theorem of parallel axis. Okay. So first we are discussing theorem of parallel axis. Okay. Question can be asked here based on these two theorems. Any one theorem can be asked to you for 3 marks. Question may be state and prove theorem of perpendicular axis, or question may be state and prove theorem of parallel axis. Each question will carry 3 marks. Only statement can be asked for 1 marks. Okay, so we are starting first with theorem of parallel axis. So here first, what is the statement here? So you have to remember the statement. So concentrate on the statement. What are the here? Statement here is, the moment of inertia of a rotating body about any axis of rotation or about any axis is equal to sum of its moment of inertia about a parallel axis passing through its center of mass and product of mass of the body and square of the distance between two parallel axes. Okay, so this is actually very long statement and it is difficult to understand. So how you will just remember the statement? So first you have to consider the consideration, that is your figure. So what we considered here, a rigid body. Suppose we consider a rigid body of any shape. We consider that this rigid body is made up of n number of elements. All these elements are identical and all the elements are having mass dm. So one of such element we considered at point P as shown in the figure. So we consider a rigid body of any shape, then we consider here continuous distribution of particle here, that is we consider the body element wise. So we will consider body is made up of n number of elements. These elements are identical, all of the elements are having mass dm. One of such element we consider at point P, which is having mass dm. Okay, what we consider, suppose we want to determine moment of inertia of this rigid body about an axis passing through point O. Okay, so for that what you will consider, you will consider the center of mass of body. Suppose we consider point C is the center of mass of this rigid body. So we will consider one axis of rotation passing through the center of mass. And both the axis of rotation here are parallel to one another. That is, one is passing through point O, one is passing through center of mass C. The perpendicular distance between these two parallel axes is H. What next here? We join the element that is present at point P. So we are joining the point P to the points O and C respectively. Okay, what next here? You will project the point along the line which is joining the two parallel axes. So what we will do here, we will draw perpendicular from point P along the line OC. So this point of intersection here, we are writing it as point D. Okay, so what we are writing our formula, suppose we consider, when we consider axis of rotation is passing through point O, in that case suppose we consider the moment of inertia of axis of rotation passing through point O is denoted by IO. Similarly, the moment of inertia of axis of rotation passing through point C, that is center of mass, is IC. So your expression will be, that is according to the statement, your formula will be here, IO equal to IC plus MH square. What is IO here? Moment of inertia about axis of rotation passing through point O. IC, that is moment of inertia of axis of rotation passing through center of mass C. Capital M is total mass of rigid body. H is perpendicular distance between two parallel axes. Okay, so according to the statement, your expression, your formula will be IO equal to IC plus MH square. That is the moment of inertia of a rotating body about any axis of rotation is equal to sum of its moment of inertia about parallel axis passing through its center of mass and the product of mass of the body and the square of distance between two parallel axes. So I hope you are getting what I said here. According to the statement, first part, if you consider the moment of inertia of rotating body about any axis of rotation is, that is your IO. So IO is equal to, what next here is sum of its moment of inertia. Sum means you will write, summation means you will write plus sign. Summation of what? First thing here considered as moment of inertia of body about the parallel axis passing through center of mass, and that we are denoting it by IC. So IC, your first term. Next here it is written product of mass of body and the square of distance between two parallel axes. So product of mass and square of distance here will be mh square. So addition, IC plus mh square will be IO. This is given in the statement. Okay, so you are getting, no, according to the figure, what is your statement. So what you will do here, how you will memorize, how you will remember your statement, figure you keep in mind, your formula you keep in mind, and based on the formula you can write your statement. Fine. Next, if proof of the theorem is asked, what you will do? So we already discussed here, we consider a rigid body of any shape. We consider this rigid body is made up of n number of elements. These elements are identical. Each of the elements are having mass dm. So one of such element we consider at point P having mass dm. What next here? We want to determine moment of inertia about axis of rotation which is passing through point O. For that we will consider one more parallel axis passing through center of mass. And the perpendicular distance between these two parallel axes we consider as h. So what we consider here, IO is the moment of inertia of axis of rotation passing through point O. IC is the moment of inertia of axis of rotation passing through center of mass C. H is the perpendicular distance between two parallel axes. Capital M is the total mass of the rigid body. Dm is the mass of the element at point P. Point P, from point P we consider a perpendicular along the line OC, and this point of intersection we are writing it as point D. Okay, what next? Next we will consider, suppose I am writing according to the definition, as we consider here distribution of particle of the rigid body element wise, that is we consider continuous distribution. So you will apply definition of moment of inertia in terms of integral, because we consider continuous distribution of particle for the rigid body. Okay, so I am writing IO. IO is the moment of inertia about axis of rotation passing through point O. So IO will be equal to, now this O point from element P is having distance OP and mass is dm. So according to the definition of moment of inertia, IO will be equal to integral. So square of the distance here will be OP square, mass is dm. So this square of the distance and mass together, this product is nothing but moment of inertia. So IO will be equal to integral OP square dm. Okay, hopefully you will remember, you remember the definition we discussed earlier in previous lecture. Definition of moment of inertia in terms of integral and in terms of summation. Okay, for continuous distribution and for discrete distribution. So for continuous distribution, as we consider element wise, we are writing integral form. Okay, next here in your figure you are observing right angled triangle, that is OPD. Okay, 90 degree at point D. So if you are applying Pythagoras theorem, you can write OP square equal to OD square plus PD square. Now this OD is actually, you can consider OC plus CD. Okay, so OD we can, OD square we can expand it as applying the formula A plus B bracket square. So OD is equal to OC plus CD square. OC plus CD. So OD square will be OC plus CD bracket square. So you will expand here OC plus CD bracket square. So you are writing here OC square plus 2 OC CD plus CD square. This is the replacement of OD square. Now second term plus PD square, as it is we are copying here. So OP square will be equal to OC square plus 2 OC CD plus CD square plus PD square. Now here, if you are observing, there is one more small right angle triangle PCD, right? For that, if you are applying Pythagoras theorem, PC square will be equal to CD square plus PD square, right? So this last two term here in your expression, you can replace is by PC square. So instead of writing CD square plus PD square, we can write PC square. So your expression will become OP square will be equal to OC square plus 2 OC CD plus PC square. Okay. Now here length you are observing here already. You can replace here as OC is nothing but H here. We are writing OP square is equal to H square plus 2 H CD plus PC square. Okay. Now here, what we will do here, we are applying the formula for moment of inertia. So what you have to do here, you will multiply each term by mass dm and you will integrate. Okay, so if you are integrating OP square and multiplying by mass dm, that is nothing but IO actually, right? So I am multiplying both side by dm and I am integrating both side. So integral OP square dm, I am writing it as IO. Okay, so this is equal to this whole, these three terms we are writing in bracket. So integral bracket H square plus 2 HCD plus CP square and multiplied whole by dm. You can now expand your bracket. Okay, so IO will be equal to, as H is constant here because the distance between two parallel axes will be constant, so H you can take out of integral, that is scalar multiplier, so H square. Now you can write integral dm, then plus 2hc dm, 2hcd dm plus cp square dm. Now this integral dm in first term is nothing but, if you are integrating the mass of the element, that is nothing but total mass. So you can write it as capital M. So your expression will become IO equal to capital M H square. That is your first term. Now second term, 2H you can take out of integral and you will integrate CD DM. Now the last term, if you are observing, that is integral CP square DM. That is nothing but moment of inertia about an axis passing through center of mass, that is IC. Okay, so this integral CP square dm, this is CP is nothing but distance of element from center of mass, so about that axis of rotation, if we consider moment of inertia as IC, so IC will be equal to integral CP square dm. So instead of writing that, we can write it as IC. Now here, so first term we are writing MH square, second term 2H integral CD dm plus last term IC. What about this middle term now? 2H is constant, that you will write as it is, but integral CD dm, C is the center of mass and D is the point of intersection when we draw perpendicular from point P, that is from the element along the line OC. Okay, so this is nothing but moment about center of mass, and moment about center of mass will become zero because it is actually balanced by one another. Okay, so moment, all the moments about center of mass will be zero, because if you are taking here one element at P, there are many large number of elements Okay, for all the elements, if you are writing this distance from center of mass, so distances will be plus and minus and they all will get cancelled. So in general, we can write all the moments about center of mass is zero. That is, your integral CD dm will be zero, right? So you can put it directly zero. So your term here will be IO equal to IC, I am taking first now. So IC plus MH square, and this middle term is already zero. So you will be getting IO equal to IC plus MH square, and that is your actually the statement of the theorem. So this is all about theorem of parallel axis. Okay, so I think so you already understood it very well. If you're finding any difficulty, you can write your confusion or question in comment box, or you can directly message to me. I will definitely reply to you. Okay, I will definitely try to satisfy you. Okay, next theorem, theorem of perpendicular axis. Incomparable with that earlier theorem, this is very easy. Okay, same question can be asked here, state and prove theorem of perpendicular axis for 3 marks, and only the statement can be asked here for 1 mark. Okay, so first thing what we will do, first we will discuss the statement. Okay, so the moment of inertia of a plane lamina about a perpendicular axis is equal to sum of its moment of inertia about two mutually perpendicular axes intersecting at point where two perpendicular axes cuts the lamina. Okay, so I think so you are not getting anything by the statement, so we will first consider the figure. So what is the figure we consider here? We consider a rigid body of any shape. Suppose you want to determine moment of inertia of this rigid body about an axis passing through point O. And that axis is actually z axis. Okay, so we want to determine moment of inertia of plane laminar body about perpendicular axis, that is the axis is perpendicular to the plane of the laminar body. Okay, that is nothing but z axis. For that, what we will do here, we will consider two more perpendicular axes which are mutually perpendicular to the z axis, which are actually intersecting, or you will consider which cuts the perpendicular axis z axis. So we consider x and y axis. These two axes are mutually perpendicular to one another, and these two axes are along the plane of the laminar body, that is inside the plane of laminar body. They are passing through the plane of laminar body, and the z axis is perpendicular to the plane of laminar body. Okay, so hopefully you are getting what we consider now. What you are doing here, you want to determine moment of inertia about an axis which is perpendicular to the plane of the laminar body, that is z axis. That is Iz, moment of inertia we are determining about z axis. For that, we consider two more mutually perpendicular axes, x and y axis, along the plane of the body, and both the axes are intersecting at the same point where z axis, that is perpendicular axis, cuts the lamina, right? So getting no? So actually what we want to prove here, we want to prove Iz equal to Ix plus Iy, right? For that, what we consider, what do you mean by Iz, Ix, Iy? So Iz is moment of inertia about an axis, about z axis. Ix, moment of inertia about x axis. Iy, moment of inertia about z axis, right? Okay, so what we consider in our figure, we consider all these three axis here. Okay, now again we consider element wise distribution, that is continuous distribution of the rigid body. So we consider rigid body is made up of n number of elements. These elements are identical, each of the element are having masses dm. Okay, so one of such element we consider at point P having mass dm. So from point O, distance we are taking OP, Similarly, if you are tracing according to the coordinate of point P is having coordinate xy. So P is at a distance x from y axis, P is at a distance y from x axis, right? So if you are observing here, you can observe here two right angle triangle, that is ONP 90 degree here at N point. Similarly, you can consider OMP 90 degree at M. What we are doing here, we are joining this P to the x and y axis, so that will, if you are joining, you will consider two perpendicular from point P along both axes. So N and M are actually making 90 degree here, that are at 90 degree angle. So any one of these right angle triangle you can consider. You can consider ONP or you can consider OMP. If you are writing, if you consider any one of the right angle triangle, if you are applying Pythagoras theorem, your diagonal will be OP always. So if you are writing, so OP square will be equal to x square plus y square, right? And according to the definition of moment of inertia, as we are considering continuous distribution, we will write definition of formula in terms of integral. So moment of inertia about x axis will be Iy, that is equal to integral x square dm, right? Because y axis is at a distance x from point P. Similarly, moment of inertia about y axis will be, moment of inertia about y axis Iy equal to integral x square dm. Similarly, moment of inertia about x-axis Ix is equal to integral y square dm, and Iz will be equal to integral OP square dm. So here, if you are applying your formula, OP square is equal to x square plus y square. So we will multiply both side by dm and integrate. So this integral OP square dm will become Iz. So that Iz is equal to integral in bracket x square plus y square outside dm. You can here expand the brackets. We are getting integral x square dm plus y square dm. So therefore Iz will be equal to Ix plus Iy. So this is your formula that you have to consider according to the statement, right? So you can write it as moment of inertia of plane lamina about perpendicular axis, that is about z axis, which is perpendicular here. So about perpendicular axis is equal to sum of moment of inertia about two mutually perpendicular axes intersecting at point where perpendicular axis cuts the lamina. That is, you have to prove Iz is equal to Ix plus Iy. Okay. So we already proved the theorem. Okay, so this is all about both the theorem. Hopefully you are getting. If you are having any confusion or any doubt, you can ask freely. Okay, either you message or either you write in comment box. I will definitely reply you. Thank you. Best of luck.